After the introduction of Quicksilver in last week's episode of Wandavision, more questions than answers have arrived in episode 6. Welcome, watchers of the Marvel Multiverse. This is the new voice of the Marvelous Wave. Let us observe all that occurs. Many were hoping that episode 6 would answer at least a few questions that have risen up after episode 5's big ending reveal. But so far, episode 6 only brings up more questions. With this, a few old theories may have been destroyed, but a few new theories may have come into play. First off, Wanda actually seems like she may be in control of everything. Despite many rumors surrounding last week's episode, Wanda seems to be acting of her own free will and volition, but also under a tremendous amount of grief and stress. Near the end of the episode, when Pietro asks her what is going on, she responds in similar fashion as she did when Vision asked a similar question. She says, "I don't know how I did it. I only remember feeling completely alone, empty. I just... endless nothingness." In many ways, she is reacting very similarly to her comic counterpart in House of M. She is changing, manipulating, and controlling the world, but it seems to be out of grief and sorrow. And the question still comes into play, how much control does Wanda really have? As we learn, when Vision ventures to the outskirts of town, anyone further from Wanda or the Source seem to be less under an active control. We find that Agnes, who accidentally took a wrong turn going into the town square, is just as stuck as the rest of the residents who live at the edge of the town. Agnes herself, although she is dressed as a witch, she does not appear to be Agatha Harkness, just a possible Easter egg instead of the actual character. And then it also seems as if she has little to no control over Vision or Pietro. She basically has to force Vision to wear the costume by making it the only thing in his closet. However, when Vision tells Wanda that he is going out to help the neighborhood watch for the evening instead of staying with her and the boys, she looks genuinely surprised that he is not following what she wants. It also seems as if Wanda doesn't know exactly what is going on in the rest of the town. She only knows what is going on in her immediate vicinity. With how much harm Wanda appears to be doing to the townsfolk, could we possibly be viewing her villain origin story? To some extent, it feels as if the expansion of her powers are based around the emotions she feels for those she cares about. And with the death of Pietro, Vision, and the possible future death of her twins if she cannot sustain them outside of the Hex, we could see a whole new version of Wanda that uses her powers to gain control rather than to help people. But this could all still just be an accident. Wanda may be in control and just not know exactly what she is doing, especially because so many of the residents seem to know what is going on, but subconsciously not be able to do anything about it. And with the twins' newfound powers hinting that they could one day become Wiccan and Speed, is there a possibility that Wanda is using Billy as a conduit to give her powers a boost? At the start of the episode, it is interesting that we find Billy seems to be in control of this episode. He narrates a couple times through, and by the end when he senses his father's Vision's need for help outside of the barrier, perhaps it is in part due to him that Wanda is able to expand it so much further. With some of these revelations, it is possible that Wanda is in more control than we think, but at the same time, not have as much control over the situation due to her emotions. This is evident when she gets emotional while talking to Pietro. Once again, as it happened with Vision previously, Pietro looks as if he is merely a corpse being puppeted by Wanda. With this happening for a second time, is it possible that Wanda is turning this quaint little town into a waking nightmare? My hope and theory, however, that this is still a possible way to get the X-Men into the MCU. Returning to Evan Peters' Quicksilver, I think it would be wasted potential not to bring the X-Men into the MCU. Some reasons I think this theory is still strong is because he acts more like Peter from the X-Men than Pietro from the MCU. There are even points where it seems like he doesn't know the entire story of Pietro and Wanda. Perhaps he is getting help from Professor Xavier, who is reading Wanda's thoughts and projecting them into Pietro's mind to help him blend in, infiltrate, or help create a door for the rest of the X-Men to pass through. And along similar lines, could Professor X also be being a buffer for the reason that Pietro looks different than he has previously in the MCU? And there's still the third possibility that someone else, like Mephisto, is actually in control. There is little evidence provided in this episode that it could actually be Mephisto, but that doesn't mean somebody else could also be in control as well. With many of the townsfolk seeming like they are only half under control, there is a possibility that Wanda is controlling their actions, but is not the one holding them prisoner. And it does seem that Pietro might have some control over some of what is going on. When Billy is narrating in the beginning of the episode, he is aware of what Billy is saying, whereas Tommy keeps doing what he is doing with little to no awareness. On top of that, Pietro is a fairly bad influence on the boys. This could be sitcom antics, but it could also be a way to influence the boys for evil. And with what he says at the end of the episode, he may not be as friendly as he seems. And Wanda kind of catches on to this when she blasts him away for saying Vision can't die twice. And why does he understand so well what is going on, and why is he okay with it? Only time will tell what is really going on in Westview and what is really going on with Wanda. After all that happens, though, the most exciting thing is the boys' powers manifesting and what that could mean for the future of the MCU. Since their powers come naturally, will they be classified as mutants or enhanced individuals? Either way, only time will tell. And what is going on outside of the barrier? With Hayward and Sword seemingly up to no good, it's up to Monica, Jimmy, and Darcy to figure out what is going on and save both Wanda, the town, and the world from Sword. For example, what was Sword doing with Vision's corpse in the first place? If they were so big on defending his living will to not be used as a weapon, why were they studying him when he could have been in cold storage? And is there a possibility Hayward has similar feelings towards superpowered individuals as Thunderbolt Ross did, thinking that they need more control over them and that they are the real threat? And what is Cataract? The only thing that we know from the files that Darcy finds is that they are labeled classified weapons intel. Is this a weapon that Sword has been researching to defend humans from all superpowered individuals? Or is it a possibility that it's related to the dead versions of Vision and Pietro that Wanda sees? Or could it be Wanda herself? With the cataract dead eyes of Vision and Pietro, as well as the red that filled Wanda's eyes at the end of the episode, it could be a possibility that Sword is seeking to make Wanda, or the dead, a weapon. And also, what is going on with Captain Rambeau? After passing through the barrier twice, it appears that her genetic material has been altered. This appears to be the possibility of her becoming Spectrum, or possibly even Captain Marvel one day. Hopefully, in the next couple episodes, we will get to see her use her newfound electromagnetic powers. With these changes, there is a possibility that she could be the only one who can stop Wanda. And also, who is this friend she has that they are meeting over the ridge? Some have speculated that it could be Reed Richards, as the Fantastic Four is confirmed to be part of the MCU, and his magnificent intellect would be of use here. We probably won't know who it is till the next episode, but we can make our speculations. With the end of the episode showing Wanda's power spreading, it appears as she gets more upset, her powers are growing. With Vision attempting to leave the town to seek help for the citizens of Westview, and finding that he cannot survive outside of the hexagon of space surrounding the town, could this be the case for Pietro and the boys as well? And as her power grows, could it be possible that this hexagon surrounds the entire world? With more questions than answers, hopefully some of the theories we have made will pay off before the end of the season. With Darcy being absorbed in the town, the Sword base turning into a circus, and Wanda getting stronger by the day, who knows what is in store for WandaVision and the MCU? Do you have any new theories on who may be in control? What do you think Sword's and Hayward's intentions are with Wanda? And what kind of weapon do you think Cataract could be? Let us know your thoughts on WandaVision in the comments below. And please subscribe to assemble and join our team, and have a great day.